This is Tech Tuesday. That was a title graphic. This is an intro. Stay tuned for a number graphic. Number 5. The Library of Congress is out to document history for the future, and what better way to capture this decade than by archiving tweets? Every public Twitter since 2006 and into the future will be documented and archived by the Library of Congress for their use in their never-ending attempts at protecting the history of America. I assume that Disney just got their next plot for Nick Cage's third National Treasure movie, National Treasure 140 Characters of Secrets. So yes, this means your legacy is your Twitter feed. Begin regretting that right about now. Number 4. So the Library of Congress is up to date on the digital world. Wonder how the Supreme Court is doing? Well, the answer is not very good. In a recent case brought before the court about the privacy police officers had on their cell phones issued by the state. But before getting into that argument, there were some important questions that needed to be answered. Like, what is the difference between email and a pager? And what happens if you get a text while sending one? Does a voice say, we appreciate your call, we'll get back to you? And another classic, could those officers print out the text messages and give them to their friends? Needless to say, those 80-something judges aren't typing away on their iPhones between hearings. The proceedings really do read like something off the Onion Radio News Network. The For Dummies series could really cash in here. Number 3. Hulu is great for watching that missed episode of Glee or that missed episode of a good show. As of now, Hulu only offers recent episodes in standard resolution, not enough to cut the cable company and watch all your TV on the internet. Well, hopefully Hulu's new service, Hulu Plus, will change that. Hulu Plus is planned to cost around $10 a month and will allow subscribers to watch older episodes of shows and possibly get more content or different viewing options. If the $10 will really allow you to cut the cable company is still to be seen, but it could be more harm than good for customers. If everyone starts dropping their cable company, taking away their $60 a month payment in favor of watching all their shows online, cable companies may start swinging the lack of net neutrality and bandwidth power around, meaning they could charge you for internet by the amount of data instead of an unlimited monthly fee. In the worst case, they could outright block Hulu from their service since there is no law saying they can't. Let's just hope the net neutrality law doesn't come up in front of the Supreme Court. What is the difference between internet and a system of tubes? Number 2. Facebook. Can't live without it, can't have personal information secure with it. Facebook is, surprise surprise, cutting even more privacy features and semi-shadily letting companies target you even better. The recent updates changed the way the privacy settings work, taking away features like hiding what pages you're a fan of, what your location is, and the profile pic that from people that aren't your friends. On top of outright eliminating these features, they made the settings menu just a bit different and more confusing, which makes it even trickier to hide your info. So I suggest you go back and take a look through all your settings to make sure nothing you don't want out there is out there. Now, I'm not saying you should think anything you put on the internet is really all that private, but Facebook is supposed to be, or used to be, one of those semi-safe havens where not every single detail you post was out there for everyone to creep. Only the creeps you are friends with. And number 1. So my second home, Gizmodo.com, is getting some serious traffic this week after they revealed the iPhone 4. I bet you're thinking, wait, Apple is the one who reveals iPhones. Well, nothing gets by you. The newest iPhone was found in a bar disguised as a 3GS, which was left by an Apple engineer. Somehow this new prototype made it out into the world to be left behind on a bar stool and then picked up by someone else who eventually sold it to Gizmodo for $5,000. Quite a journey. Gizmodo then tore it apart to see its insides, then put it back together and gave it back to Apple. After all that, the cops then came to the editor of Gizmodo's house and took all his personal computers in search for the iPhone and its data. This is the first major security breach Apple's had in, well, forever, and for it to go all the way into a physical prototype in the hands of a tech blog is just bad. Feature-wise, the new iPhone has both a regular camera with a flash and a front-facing camera for video chat. A larger battery will let you have plenty of talk and surf time, and a new screen offers far better video quality, and a full body redesign makes it slimmer, sleeker, and more reminiscent of Macs with hard lines and metallic surfaces. Get a full look inside and out over at Gizmodo, and get a full look at my envious face wanting it right here. That's all for this week. I know it's been a while, but remember, Tech Tuesday on YouTube over at youtube.com/TechTuesday. It's tons of fun, I promise. I'll see you next week.